Inauguration Day will be game day. You practice on offense and you practiced on defense so that when game day came, you were well prepared to win the game.
Mike White was a member of the Secret Service for almost three decades. He was the special agent in charge of presidential protection under President Obama and stayed on when President Trump took office in 2017. That meant he was front and center during President Trump's inauguration.
On that day, from my recollection, I was more concerned about a threat from the air, a drone or an aircraft, but I was just as concerned that somebody could throw something from the crowd or that somebody could, in one way or another, infiltrate the security posture that had been set up.
Presidential inaugurations have always been targets. In 2009, President Obama's first inauguration faced threats from the terror group Al-Shabaab. Back in 1861, there was even an unsuccessful white supremacist plot to assassinate President Lincoln en route to his first inauguration. In 2005, officers along President Bush's parade route even confiscated apples and bananas from the crowd so nothing could be thrown. It's the job of the Secret Service to prepare for and prevent any of these potential threats, from nuclear attacks to civil disobedience. And this year, the events of January 6th meant security threats were top of mind.
This year, I think things are extremely heightened because of the events that took place at the Capitol.
For President Trump's 2017 inauguration, there were almost 8,000 National Guard troops stationed around D.C. This year brought in over 25,000. That's more than the number of guardsmen currently deployed overseas. You can see them throughout the district, forming checkpoints and blocking off access to sites like the Washington Monument. Inauguration planning starts about a year in advance. As a type of National Special Security Event, or NSSE, presidential inaugurations are coordinated by the Secret Service.
NSSE requires that everyone that attends the event is put into a protective bubble, if you will. So the NSSE makes the Secret Service be responsible for every public person, the press, all the staff, everyone that's involved in the event.
That's different from the usual job of the agency, which is just protecting individuals like the president and their family. For a special event like an inauguration, the Secret Service has to coordinate among dozens of federal and local agencies. It also involves working with private companies like Amtrak and cell providers to secure the entire district.
So water supplies or power supplies, all of those things could be impacted through a breach, a cyber breach of some kind. So it is extremely important for us to work with private sector partners in that critical infrastructure area to make sure that everything is safe.
Mike says it's not unique to see law enforcement working around the clock in the weeks leading up to the inauguration.
I know I slept in my office, and I know previous agents in charge for the president's detail did the same. I'm talking about during the planning process, the weeks up before the inauguration.
Most of the work is done by the time you see them guarding street corners.
Closer to the event, you're going to switch gears somewhat into making sure that you have effective and capable response elements and operational units that can address any problems that may come up based on intelligence or events that happen prior to the event.
In typical years, that means rehearsing the inauguration from the parade to the ball and anticipating any threats.
You train and prepare for just about every threat that's imaginable, and that can be peaceful protesters that maybe were to try to block the route of the motorcade, all the way to a massive coordinated type situation.
The pandemic made those sorts of trainings harder this year, but it's also meant far fewer crowds to worry about.
I know in the past you've had hundreds of thousands of people show up, and they have to be screened. They have to go through magnetometers. Any items that they have with them have to be searched. Those components won't necessarily be as necessary.
The screening in 2021 also looked at law enforcement itself. Nearly 30 off-duty cops were identified as participants at the Capitol riot. The FBI vetted individual National Guard troops, and just a day before Biden's inauguration, two troops were removed from their inauguration posts because of links to far-right militia groups.
I do think there may be issues or incidents, and those don't have to be security issues. It could be the weather, but I think on the security front, we're in pretty good shape.